Hello everyone and welcome to New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host Richard Evans. Make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. So today I'd like to show you how to use the TriCaster control panel to control Emems and Comps. Now Emems are a way to store different mix effect setups and Comps are ways to store different shots within your Emems, giving you a ton of flexibility into your mix effects and virtual sets, and using the TriCaster control panel to trigger these makes customizing your production super duper easy. Now there's a lot to unpack here today, so let's get down to it. All right, so we're gonna start off in the TriCaster TC1 interface, and there's a lot of things to cover here, so please bear with me. I'm gonna do a quick review of what Emems and Comps can do for you and how to trigger those within the TriCaster interface. All right, so on the TriCaster interface, you can kind of think of Emems as a way to save different channel states, and you have 9 of those to choose from. So for this example today, I'm going to do that with my mix effect, my trusty mix effect number 2, and open that one up like this. And I currently have my mix effect number 2 set up to just be a 2-layer switcher here. So I have input 3 over here in layer A, input B on 4, and I have my guitar transition there, so I can do goofy things like this and switch between them and use mix effect number 2 as a secondary mixing source. Okay? Now what I want to do is I want to save this particular mix effect state for the way it is. I want to be able to recall it at the touch of a button. So I'm going to go over to the left side of my screen, and you'll see that I have this little blue caret here. When my mouse gets close to it, it expands, and I have 9 different presets to choose from here. So to save that, I can just click the camera button here, and that will save a preview of that. Now, what's cool about this is I can right-click on it and say I can rename it to whatever I want. I can export it so that I can use this for later on down the road in a different session or different TriCaster, and import it from my export of something else, or just clear it out. Okay, so we have that Emem set up for number 1. All right, so again, mix effects can be used for a variety of different reasons. Not only can I use them as a mix, but I can also use them for an effect, like a virtual set, for example. So let's go ahead and load in a virtual set. And we can do that by going over here, clicking on the transition I currently have set up, and let's click on this virtual set that I've already have loaded up here. And now let's go ahead and fill in all of these different blanks with the way we want our show to look. All right, so we're gonna go with input number 2, which is my gentleman here on his keyed out green screen on layer A. Cool, he's behind his virtual set the way I need him to be. And that screen behind him, I wanna make that my New Tech logo. So I'll click on buffer number 2, and we're pretty good there. Okay, so now let's go through and save this in an Emem as well. So we'll go back over to the left and click on number 2. Boom. All right, now we have mix effects number 2 saved there. So let's say we want to go back, and we're not using a virtual set right now. We only have 4 mix effects to choose from. So let's go ahead and switch that back over to a switcher. All I have to do is recall that by clicking on Emem 1. Boom, there we go. Right on. And if I want to bring it back to a virtual set, click like that. I don't have to go through and select every little thing in order to make that combined into a mix effect. So you can switch between different mix effect states by using your Emems, which is very powerful. All right. So again, you have 4 different mix effects, and they each have their own Emem, 9 Emem slots there. So that's math. What is that? 38 different Emems to choose from. All right. Now within every Emem is now 16 different comps. And let me show you how to get to comps next. So comps are going to be, if you think of Emems as a way to save the channel states of your mix effect, comps are going to be where you could go to, organize the different shot choices or animations that you want to use within each of your mix effects. All right, so let me go ahead and open up my comps here. All right, so let me clear out the one that I had earlier. And so what I want to do is I'm going to use this shot to then be my establishing shot for this particular mix effect. And we'll save that into comp number one by clicking on that picture. Boom. So we got a wide shot there. And again, I can right click on it, rename it, update it, yada, yada, yada. All of that information will be saved inside of our emems. Okay. So now let's go ahead and zoom into our virtual set here. Let's go ahead and grab that. All right. And now let's save that comp into number two. All right. So check this out. Now this allows me to do some really fun, complicated, different animations. So instead of just being a cut back to number one, what it'll do now is if I click on comp number one, it then does a slow zoom back to our establishing shot. And we can control the speed of all of that here within the comp window. All right. So not only can you have it set up to camera zooms like this, but you can also use it to trigger some pretty cool animations. So let me go ahead and do that real quick by bringing in my downstream keyer, sorry, my upstream keyer number three. And there's my little stormy cloud there in the top left. So now what I want to do is I'm going to do something pretty interesting here. What I want to do is then I want to have my storm cloud do a little animation and bring that kind of full screen on top of my shot here. So let's go ahead and save this comp first. Go in here and let's bring it down to number 9. You don't have to necessarily put them in order. All right. And now I'm going to grab my positioning tool here. And let's position this to be right in the center. And we'll zoom it up, scale it pretty big. And then for the rotation, let's put in 360 degrees. All right, when I hit enter, it looks like nothing happened because 360 degrees is, you know, zero. But if I go into comps, that will treat it completely differently. All right, so let's save that into number 10 here. All right, and now if I hit 9, check this out. There goes my little storm cloud, and it will spin, adjust, and go back to that original position that I had it in. All right, let's make the animation go a little bit faster. And there he goes, spinning and right smack dab in the center. Okay, so that's how you can control your different state changes and then save them using comps so you can do some cool animations and stuff like that. Okay, now let's move over to the control panel side of things to kind of show you how we can then use the control panel to do this. So I know that was a pretty long overview here, but saves you from having to go back and watch a bunch of videos. All right, so ta-da, control panel. So what I want to do here, we're gonna kind of combine a lot of different things that we've shown before. And first thing I wanna do is I want to have my top stripe here be assigned to the mix effect that I'm working on. And to review, we'll click delegate stripe and then mix effect 2. All right, so now anything that I do up here will now be applied to mix effect number 2 and main will stay the same. All right, now I'm gonna also have my interface open a little bit here so we can kind of see these things happen in real time. All right, so let's go through and take a look over on my emem for mix effect number 2. Now to access the emems here, let me go ahead and zoom into my control panel and take a closer look. All right, so the buttons that we're going to be focusing on here are this one, which is mem, and then comp, and then we're also going to be using control and alt here in conjunction with these. And let me show you how to do that. So let me zoom out a little bit here so we can see a little bit, so you can see my buttons here at the bottom, and then also what I'm working with on my top stripe here. Okay, so what I want to do now is let's go through and let me get rid of this storm cloud here and let's just load up comp number 1. All right, so let's say I want to clear out what's going on. Actually, no, let's just go ahead and punch these up first. Let me show you how to punch them up before we start going into editing them. So if I wanted to punch up my emem number 1, I would click memory, just hold it down, and then now you'll see on my mix effect 2, this lights up between 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, because I have my 9 different emems there. So press number 1, Boom, and we went back to our mix effect emem number one, and I can go and also click number two, and that will load that up. Now, keep in mind, let me do that again just to show you here, whenever I switch between these, that it did take a few seconds to load up that particular virtual set once I had switched it over to my, from my switcher to my virtual set. So keep that in mind when you're doing these. It does take a few seconds, so I wouldn't necessarily do it while it's on air. Cut away to something else, then bring it on, you're good to go. All right, now now what I wanna do is, let's go ahead and I'm gonna bring up emem number one again. And I wanna also show you, that's how you just how you recall them. But you can also use your control panel to delete or clear different emems and then also program them. So let's go ahead and delete the first one here. I'm gonna press emem here. And then I'm also going to press alt like that. So I'm holding down mem and alt, and now I have my 9 different presets up here, and that will allow me to clear one of the emems I'm working with. So let's do that by clicking one, and you'll see that one has been emptied, all right? And if I then hold down memory and press comp number one, well, nothing happens because I didn't have anything saved there. So I will then say go through and hold mem and then also hold control, and that will allow me to write them in like so. Ta-da! And now that one is back and we're pretty much good to go there. All right, now on the comps side of things, let's take a look at that. So I'm gonna again load up my mem number two here. There's a lot to go through. All right, so now let's open up on the interface so you can see what I'm doing, the different comps that I have loaded into that. All right, so right now we are in this particular comp. Let me clear out this first one again. And now what I wanna do is we'll combine all of this. So we have this wide shot here, and then now I'm gonna hold down comp. And when I do that, you'll see that it has my 1 through 16 available to me up here, so comp. And let's hit control, and we will save that to number one. All right, and then now let's go ahead and zoom my camera in, like so, and say comp, control, save that to two, and I got that good to go. So same rules apply there, hold down the button, and control to program what you want to be there. Hold down comp and alt to clear it out, or just hold down comp and that'll allow you to just punch up the number and call it up like this. So I have that there. And now let's go back to number one and we will zoom out to our wide shot. All right, let's go back to our close up here and we will do the same thing, but now using that upstream keyer here. So let's do that. Let's bring on our upstream keyer number, what number was it? Number three. All right, bring that on screen there, like so. All right, now let's go ahead and save that to comp. Oh, I almost did the wrong button there. So comp, and then hold down control, and we'll save that into comp number, what was I using before? 9? There you go. All right, have that there. And now let's, I'm on the wrong thing. See, have to review these things. Go back to number three here. All right, so now I'm able to adjust the position. So I'll adjust position of that right over his face, scale it up a little bit. Right, and then we'll use rotation here. And I'm just gonna flip it 360 degrees like I did in my previous example. All right, bam, like so. All right, now we'll save that by holding comp, control, and we'll go to 10. All right, now leave that the way it is, go to comp, and let's click on 9, and there goes the animation of my stormy cloud. Yay! And as you saw when I did that, you saw that I'd accidentally been messing around with my camera when I had the live set on there. So there are ways for you to make some different mistakes. And if you want to clear it out, hey, not a big deal. You would just hold down comp, alt, and then just clear those out and you can start your animation over. So there's a lot of cool things that you can do with comps and emems. And again, if you're working with a TriCaster like TC1 or TriCaster Mini, for example, you have four different mix effects to choose from, plus your main switcher row. And if we do the math on that, every row has its own 9 different emems, plus 16 different comps within those emems, gives you 500, like over 500 different mix effect configurations to choose from. And if you're using like a TriCaster TC2 or a VMC unit, that gives you like over 1,200 different combinations to work with here. So there's a lot of powerful things you can do in the TriCaster that's mind-blowing sometimes that I forget that are here, but using the control panel like we got here is definitely going to make your life in Emem and Comp land a lot easier. Yeah! So as you can see, using the control panel to control your Emems and Comps is a simple and effective way of streamlining your shows. Now, if you like this video and would like to see similar tutorial videos on New Tech products, click subscribe on the New Tech YouTube channel at youtube.com/newtechinc. For formal New Tech product training, you can sign up for New Tech University, which is available at newtech.com/newtech-u. And for information on New Tech products and services, contact your local reseller or you can visit our website, newtech.com. And lastly, if you are sharing your work on social media using New Tech products, tag us using the hashtags NewTech or TriCaster. That's all for this episode. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time for the next edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials.